Welcome to a very short introduction on Walking in the City by Michel Desertel. Now, this is an often discussed and much read and interpreted, debated essay in the field of cultural studies and in many other fields, because largely served through a Jesuit philosopher and theoretician. Brought in something which we can easily call or understand as is putting into practice whatever that he had been reading, let it be in psychology, let it be in history, let it be in architecture, and trying to put it in a relation with the everyday life practices of ordinary people. So something which makes her too special in the readings today is the ordinary life practices which he tries to put in or put in through his essays. And Walking in the City is actually one of those essays wherein Sertu tries to make the maximum utilization of various theories with which he tries to counter the power structures of the society. And Sertu does not overtly say he does not really give you an imminent picture of somebody consciously trying to subvert the parameters of the power structures. But this is something which we all unconsciously engage in one way or the other. And what Sertu does in this particular essay is to make us conscious about the unconscious activities which we do, wherein we are unconsciously trying to kind of thwart the power structures and positions of hegemony which act knowingly or unknowingly in our day-to-day lives. So basically, this essay is a poetic semiotic analysis of daily urban life, and it was, as already I mentioned, one of the most influential essays in cultural studies, wherein how much of a daily practice or a day-to-day activity holds power when it is positioned against the larger power structures in society. Now, Sertu actually begins the essay by talking about a view from the 110th floor of the World Trade Center. And that panoramic view of the entire city is breathtaking. You feel like, the Icarus who flies above the devices of Daedalus. And the spectator can basically read a universe which is constantly exploring. It gives you an eye of the god. And you feel that your body is no longer clasped by the twists and turns of the streets, and you are actually looking at an entire universe at your leisure for your pleasure. Now, Sertu says, in contrast to this particular view, the view of the ordinary practitioners of the city, that is the walkers, he calls them the walkers, they are actually people whose body flows through the thicks and thins of an urban text. And he kind of, in this particular essay, tries to compare the very act of walking to writing a text, which is why I said in Sertu's essay, you will have literary theory, you will have literature, you will have psychoanalysis, you will have many, many, many other things coming in, seeping in through the different gaps which he lets in the essays. So these ordinary practitioners of the city are nobody but just walkers who actually goes through the zigzagging pattern of the city and writes a text, which is something which counters the meta narrative of looking from above. So these walkers, in Sertu's own terms, are like blind lovers in each other's arms, who actually escapes the totalizing power with the strangeness of every day. Just like blind people have got every day a strange day, the walkers in the city, they actually embrace this kind of strangeness, and that is how they try to flout the familiarity of the city, which is quite often made probable by the people who plan the city, the Urban Planning Development Corporation, maybe for instance, those people who map the city. So what these workers do is basically to go against the entire mapping, that totalizing project, that panoptic surveillance, that mode wherein a monolithic or a homogenizing tendency is made effective and visible in the city. And Sarko talks about city as an operational concept. Now, it produces its own space, and it is a space which is devoid of anything waste. City always rejects waste. The urban space does not have anything or any space for the waste. So basically, there is a substitution of the traditional by flattening out all the data in a plane projection. And that is what people do when they map the city. So as to create something which is called city, which is quite stable and which actually tries to bring together every differences under one umbrella, which actually tries to efface whatever that is differential and tries to unify everybody together so that city can act like a single subject. Okay, now this city actually becomes a new subject, and this is enriched years and years and becomes a hero in the machine of modernity. Now, this city, this monolithic structure called city, or this monopolizing tendency of city, is something which you can counter only with everyday practices, according to Sarko. Because without any specific conscious, points of identity, the workers themselves combat this structure of modernity. And he says this is the return of the practices, or this is how practices actually turn around and try to counter the very structure which limits the possibilities of their walking around. So the way to counter the panoptic is in the day-to-day, minuscule everyday practices. The flawlessness of the system can be countered only by actually bringing out certain flaws in the system, or by working through the system. So it is when the workers walk in the city, through the different streets, they turn, and when they refuse to follow the patterned map which the city actually projects in front of them, that everyday lived practice is actually something which counters this very particular structure, this panoptic power of the city. Now, he says there, story begins on ground level with footsteps. So the story of countering the city actually begins on ground level. It actually begins on the foot, or with the foot. I'm so sorry to say there is a mistake in the spelling over there. It is not their story, it is T-H-E-I-R story. So there is a chorus of the idle footsteps which actually, goes against the busy city. So that is how people actually, or the workers in the city actually counter the universalized concept called city. So they don't localize, but they spatialize, because you cannot really know where the workers are going to. You cannot really, map the walking pattern of people. I mean, there are several walking projects all across the world. And one of those walking projects I still remember was to, follow someone who you do not know, a complete stranger, trace his path and until he enters an indoor building. And that was actually a project which was done worldwide. And what they intended through the project was to show how undefined, unpredictable the walkers are. And that is why they said such pedestrian movements cannot be contained. They cannot be labeled. They cannot be compartmentalized. So when you window shop, or when you simply go for a walk, I mean, there is no specific pattern in your mind. Maybe you have a specific pattern in your mind, but maybe after 5 minutes you feel that anyway I'm going on a leisure walk, so why not take a different route? So it is actually something which allows you to draw a line against the city map. And even though the workers inside the city keep moving, they actually move beyond the patterned map. So there is this rhetoric or this language of walking, which is basically used so as to overthrow the power of city politics. And Sarthu quotes the example of a woman who walks on unnamed roads unconsciously, because basically what she does is to walk on unnamed roads is to walk against the meta-narrative of the city, which is carefully planned and named by the city planners. So unconsciously, she actually walks against the agenda of the city planner. And often the city offers the locals nothing except their own homes. There is a lack of memory in the very concept of city planning. So walking actually, you know, helps in inventing a space for yourself. You reside in a city for a long time, and when someone asks you, what is the memory that you have about the city, you don't talk about you seldom talk about the monuments, whatever the city planners have actually, you know, had in their mind when they built a monument. You actually talk about the home, the place where you reside, the family maybe. So basically, the order in the city, which is imposed by all these memorials or monuments or, you know, artifacts and architecture, which tries to glorify the city, it is actually torn open by ellipses and by the very act of writing stories by walking. So for Sarthu, the very act of walking itself is a story which moves against the meta-narrative of the city.